Quotient returns the integer part of the result of dividing the two arguments. Mod, on the other hand, returns the remainder of an integer division between the two arguments. These two functions work both with floating point values or with integer values. We will start looking at them with integer values because they are much easier to understand, and then we will see the result also with floating point values. Here I'm generating two series of numbers, val1 and val2. Val1 contains numbers from 3 to 6 with a step of 1, and val2 contains numbers 2, 3, and 4. I will use val1 as the numerator and val2 as the denominator of a division. The first result is using divide, so it returns a floating point value. Quotient, on the other hand, returns the result of the integer division, so it will contain only the integer part of the division. Mod contains the remainder. The remainder is always a number that is less than the denominator. We will also see how to use the mod. Indeed, if you want to retrieve again the decimal part, you need to take the mod and divide it by the divisor in order to obtain the decimal part of the division. So if we take, for example, 6 divided by 2, the result is 3 with no remainder. Indeed, quotient returns 3 and mod returns 0. But if we divide 6 by 4, the result is 1.50, which, using only integer math, results in 1 with a mod of 2. 2 needs to be divided again by 4 in order to return 0.50, which was the decimal part of the division. The same calculation can be executed also with floating point values. The results are the same, they are just a bit harder to understand. Indeed, if the number starts from 0.5 to 3.3 with a step of 1.6, and the denominator goes from 0.5 to 2.8 with a step of 1.1, these numbers are chosen only to create decimal numbers, you see that if you divide 2.10 by 1.60, the result of the division is 1.31, which is 1 with a modulus of 0.50. In order to read the modulus correctly, you take 0.50, you divide it again by 1.60, and you obtain 0.31, which is the decimal part of the original division.